All right. Here I am, live streaming. Version 5.010 was just released this morning. So we're going to start a new career mode. Western Front. World War One. We're going to play as German. We're going to go 1918, April 1st. We have a lot of options here. I'm thinking we might go down to Verdun, because I've already done 5-day campaign from, what was it? One of these ones. I think it was Jasta 35, 32 or something. 22S, I don't know. So this time we're going to go down to Verdun. Yeah, thinking maybe just this one, 65, or maybe 64W. Let's have a look at who we're going up against. Spads, stop with triplanes, Spads. Lots and lots of Spads. I guess it's all the French and Americans. Oh look, there's more down here. Yeah, it's just more Spads. And the odd triplane here and there. Alright. Gonna go just to 65. Although if we go down this one, we might fly down here as well. As over Verdun. This one, there's just a lot of forests, no man's land. There's this one, there's a few rivers, train tracks. Yeah. Go 64. Actually, can I even join that? I don't think I can. I don't think I can. I think it's only the green ones I can join. So in that case, I can only join this one. What? Come on. Alright, maybe we could go up here. I don't want to fly the triplane. DR1, because I don't really like it that much. It's too slow. Well, I guess guess we're going to this one then. Let's have a look. That's a big airfield. Whew. We're going to join just at 8. That guy. Yeah, that's good enough. Let's go Craftsman. I'm not going to read all this because can't be bothered. I'm going to turn Iron Man mode on, so if we die, we're dead. No restarts. Welcome to the Western Front. All right. Unit headquarters. These are our fellow people that we're flying with. Of course, Richthofen in first place for victories. Voss, Bulker, Wolf. Those are like the only ones I know. Alright, next day. Come on. Cloudy weather, 1200 meters, right. And fog. Sounds exciting. Enemy planes have been spotted crossing our front lines. Got intercept attackers. It's the first mission of the day. It's at 5 in the morning. I might yawn a lot. Just finished work. I'm pretty tired. We're doing this one free hunt down at Lemmes. Ours is at 6 p.m. Let me just adjust all this. Balloon defense mission is the next one at 2 o'clock. All right, 6 p.m. Here we go. We're gonna go have everything off except for spectators because I don't like the boundary that VR sets. So it's full realistic apart from that. We're not going to be using spectating anyway. Ugh. I think I need to set up the altitude throttle for this plane. or at least in the F model. I'm not flying that one, but I'll do it anyway for the next time, in case I don't forget, or in case I forget. Looks pretty good. Let's have a look. Does it tell me? No, of course not, because it's not. This one doesn't even have it. Ooh, nice looking plane. What JAST are we flying again? 65? I don't know, we'll just leave it. I don't think Rise of Flight had this color scheme. We're gonna fly with no streamer, because we're not the flight leader. We're gonna take up a white scarf and a Luga. And we're also gonna take up a thermometer and bullet counters. And probably a light. ...250 convergence is good. Damn, what a nice looking plane. Alright. Let me just reset the view here. Hey, what do they get? Oh no, he's got the same as me. Oh, they'll be the F ones. This D7Fs. Alright, people, taking off. I'm going next. Whoa, why is my rudder not working? Oh shit. Did I not turn on the... Damn it. I have to relaunch the game. Well, mission one failed. I didn't have my peripherals turned on. I think I did this last time. I started my last campaign at day 2 and called it day 1 because the first mission, I didn't have all my devices turned on. Great. Let me just relaunch the game here. Here we go. This game takes so long to load. Oh no, it's actually going by pretty quick. Well, it gets to the end and then it takes ages. So he's already nearly finished. It's finished, apparently. But then it sort of just glitches as it loads. I don't know how loud I am and how loud the game's gonna be. but I'll watch the recording back after and I'll adjust it for the next one. So if you can't hear me talking during the flight, then that's too bad. Okay, I'm on. Right, there we go. Korea. Joseph von Gleisenberg, I guess. Pretty much the same weather as yesterday. Of June, 16th of June. All right. Next day from our failed attempt. So by the looks, if we fly an F model, then we get the fancy looking paint skin, whereas the normal one just has this green thing. Ah, nope. Average weather, clouds are now 1,400 meters. No more fog. Slight, very light wind. We've got an additional regular model and an F model, and the newspaper has been delivered. Right. I'm not going to read any of that. Oh, I've got two missions today. Balloon defense at 6 in the morning and escort attackers at 6 at night. Let's have a look. Balloon defense down here and escort attackers down here. All right. Gonna start the mission. And this time, I'm going to double check my controls before the planes take off. So that I don't end up swerving in front of the other ones like last time. Oh, we're flying an F model this time. We get the fancy skin. And again, thermometer. Oh, this one doesn't have bullet counters. Maybe they come standard. Yes. Come standard. Why have we only got 60 liters this time? I'm gonna leave it. Just leave it the way it is. Although that's quite a long flight. Your mission is to provide air cover for an observation balloon near the front line. The enemy is trying to deprive us of reconnaissance from these observation points. Spotters from the balloon warn you of enemy aircraft with flares and direct you to intercept you at their approach. You can only return to base after following the spotter's instructions. You may return to base only after following. Oh, yeah. Successfully completing this mission will be followed by a mission critical objective completed message. All right. So I guess I do have to set up the throttle then. Let me do that now. Key mapping, engine controls. Looking for. This one, D7F engine altitude throttle. Except, okay, hang on. Does it tell us in here? But a new BMW, high altitude, much better performance, maximum throttle capable of generating 250 horsepower ground level for short time with nominal. Hang on, hang on, hang on, hang on, hang on. For a short time with a nominal rating of 330 horsepower and newly designated carburetor. Okay, engaging at low altitudes could lead to engine malfunction, detonation. So, what altitude do I set it at? I may just. The last one was 7,000 meters, this one's 9,000. Doesn't tell me when to use the altitude throttle. We're just gonna leave it. All right, that's working, that's working. Good. Oh, I'm being left behind. Here we go. Takeoff successful. I'm going to turn the HUD off. Actually, no, I'll leave it on. Seems kind of important. Alright. I'm looking for the radiator control. Oh, there it is. So when it's pushed in, I think it's closed. Yeah, the temperature is going up. So when you pull it out, temperature should go down. Let me turn light on. Don't really need it, just leave it off. Yeah, okay, so close the throttle, we'll close the radiator about halfway. I didn't check how many pilots took up. So there's six of us. I only see three and me. There should be five others. I don't know. There's that giant, giant airfield. While we're going slow, with zero throttle. So our fuel gauge right in the middle, we only took 60 litres, so that's on 60 now, like 59. So we've got to keep an eye on that. Let me turn the instrument panel off. Where's the eye on the keyboard? No. There it is. Well, we're turning. Oh, there's someone. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think that's the fifth one over there. I'm wingman number 3. So I should be in between these two. Number 33 and... it's his number, I can't read it. So we just turned left, so I think we're at checkpoint 1. We should be heading south. Where's the compass on this thing? There it is. Yeah, we're heading south, slightly east. 31, so I must be 32. Can't read it. 30 and 29 is flight lead. Should also have a streamer, which means that one back there is probably 34. So our airfield should be that tiny one next to the massive one. Yeah, our airbase looks so small in comparison. Like, that's a huge field. Cold. I would have liked to fly the Albatross, but there was no squadron that I could select in Verdun area apart from this one. So we're stuck in this plane, which is actually a better plane, I think. It's a lot faster, probably turns better. But I like the Ultras. Oh my goodness, they're flying so slow. You know what, I'm going to fly on this side. I don't feel comfortable on that side because they're so close to me. So we've already used up 4 litres of petrol. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, yeah. Already at 56. And we haven't even got to the front lines yet. Where are we? There's two small rivers. like these two, maybe. There's a big one. There's a small one. So I think that forest there is this one. So we're probably like here somewhere. Oh. The engine is very cold. Close the radiator, put it right in. Should probably swap oil and water grade because it's awkward to use. Awkward to use. There's a river coming up. It's this one right here. Once I get used to the area, I mean, it's pretty simple. Like, there's a big forest, there's a river, and there's the airstrip. And then over there's Verdun, which will be to our right. Yep, I can see it. I guess I should get information. Stop. Number 34 is in a regular one. Can't see. Formation. I can barely see them. This is not very comfortable to fly like this. Engine temperature is hot. Oh, they're turning. Above the river, yes we are. So we're right here. The Conflans. Conflans? So we're about halfway to the front line, and we've got 54 liters of fuel, so it's taken us 6 liters to fly halfway, so that's 12 liters each way. That's 24 just for the round trip. That means I got about 36 flying around over the target or anywhere else. So 36 is quite a lot considering it's 24 for the whole trip. I guess they use 60 for like normal flights, and then like they went up to 95 for like really really long ones. I don't know. Why else does it go to 60? I don't know if anyone can hear me, if anyone's watching, but it is what it is. Well, the engine is cold again. Like this radiator. I like the Albatross one. It's like a handle to the right side, and you can see exactly where it is. This one's just a tiny wee pin that you pull in and out. It's hard to see where it is. I'm gonna look down awkwardly at it. And I guess in real life you'll just reach down, pull it in and out, but like, in the game I can't physically feel it, so I don't know. This is the 6 a.m. flight. Got another one at 6 p.m. There's balloon defense. There's someone over the front lines. But the balloon's picking up. That'll be our balloon in the center there. I feel like we're taking out way too many of the F models, because we've got one normal model, and they said that in the briefing, that there's like only a third or a fourth of them with the upgraded ones. So essentially, if there's five of us, there should only be like one or two that are using the faster ones. Not like the majority with one regular. Oh well. Yeah. We're definitely flight number 32. 29, 30, 31, 32, 33. And the brown one is 34. I think this one we're flying on day one, number 34. See the front lines coming up. Oh no, the balloon. What's this? Is that the balloon? I don't know. I don't know where these circles are coming from. Oh. Oh. Ooh. Open it just a little bit. I really like the look of the brown one. Oh, there's a balloon. That looks like a friendly balloon. Maybe that's our balloon. What about here? When we get to the balloon, we'll see how much petrol we've used. Is that you, Caleb? Don't turn the light out. No, I'm live streaming, by the way. I've already used 10 litres of petrol. I'm not even at the balloon yet. This update came out this morning. They added a career mode for World War One. You know, like you get like a pilot, you choose a squadron, and you go day by day, mission by mission, and you get one life. And you can see like at the time on that day, you can see like what the top aces were. So it's all like historical and stuff, and if you actually get on the list, you can see your name on there. So my guy's name is, what was it, I can't remember, it's like Richard or something, Jeff, I don't know. Joseph, I think his name is. I think that's the balloon up there. Wait, that looks like an enemy balloon. Go with that. What? Alright. I can see planes up ahead. Trying to concentrate. I can see four planes over there and two somewhere down there. I could see them earlier. Oh, there they are. Two there, four there, and a balloon, enemy balloon. It's on our side of the trenches, so maybe it's friendly. I don't know. It looks like an enemy balloon. I can hear a siren. Holy moly, there's planes up there too. Oh, they're doing something. What's going on? What's going on? The game's starting to slow down because my computer can't handle it. My computer can't handle everything. It's like in slow motion. Ugh, this is painful. What are we doing? What's our flight leader doing? Why is he diving like that? What are you doing? Where's the rest of our planes gone? I think that's him right there. Ugh. Is he dead or something? No. What's he doing? You gonna pull up, or are you gonna keep flying downwards? Oh look, there's the rest of them. I don't know what they're doing. Why are they flying so slow? Whoa, 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 don't fly into me, crazy lunatic. Like up here somewhere. I didn't see any instructions from the balloon. There's a lot of planes over there. Why did we like dive to the ground and head north? This is weird. Why are they flying so slow? Are we heading back already? We only just got here. Got 36 liters to use up. Look at these two flying perfectly in formation. And they're clipping through each other and they just collided. Goodbye. Idiots. Oh, he missed the tree. He survived. That's a bug. This update has just been released, so there might be bugs. Right, we are currently up here, so I guess we're heading back. Alright, well, I'm going to go ahead. Full throttle. Head north. This is this way. Turn the light on. Do 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 do. Should have called it pointless patrol. Pointless patrol. Pointless patrol. Pointless patrol. I can see why the front lines go before the hills. Like trying to get through that. Or is they trying to push through the flat bit? And that's why it's so, you know, like there's hills all the way down here. And then as soon as the hill ends, the trenches come right back. We turn on autopilot so I don't have to fly the plane. Then I can have a look around at the scenery. Oh shit, there's something going on back there. Maybe they weren't going back, maybe they were hunting someone. Oh, I'm missing the action now. An enemy plane right there. Definitely enemy planes. Looks like a SPAD right in front of me. It is a SPAD. Reload the guns. It's a SPAD 7. Whoa! Woo! Right, this enemy friendly. Okay, there's the enemy. He's smoking. Stop a lot of bullets. I think he's going down. I'm not sure. Now he's going down. Is that number 34? I think it is. Moritz von Gravenruth. Yeah, it is. Who's the rest of the people? Where's the rest of them? Back now. 40 liters, we've used a third of our petrol. Currently right here-ish. Yeah, about here. That guy's following us. The others got shot down. It's quite hilly terrain over there. So I went to look at my hand in the game. I'm like, whoa, my hand's invisible. So, oh, that's right, I'm in virtual reality. It was so weird. That's right, I'm not actually flying a plane. Right, we're right here at this river. At the river. I'm so hungry. Oh, there's a plane over there. There's a plane. I can see a plane. Surely that's not an enemy this deep into our territory. Right. Game's sped up because it's like trying to catch up to the slow motion that was doing earlier. So now everything's like fast motions. Woo, woo! And we're zipping around. Whee! I think that's a friendly. There's that giant aerodrome thing. I think it's one of our teammates coming back to base. Oh, I lost him. I don't know where he is now. I'm just gonna keep heading north. Just gonna keep heading north. It's like a tiny wee town here. I think that we should be above a town. Ah, yep. That's that town. Oop. Another town over there. There's that airfield. I want to see the tiny wee town. I think that might be it down there. It's like two buildings. No, it can't be. Because that one's between. I think that one's there. River, forest. Yeah, it's that one up there. That town and that town. Or those two towns. And then we've got the giant airfield. To a town next to our tiny wee one. Our tiny, tiny wee airfield. way is the wind going? Calm. Oh, there are no winds. Turbulence below clouds. I think it was 1 meter a second, wasn't it? Or was that yesterday? No, I think it might be no wind. So we can land from any direction. So I might land, there's the Thalia. Cut the throttle. Close the radiator. We're gonna circle until we lose airspeed and then land. We're just gonna come in right now, land on this brown bit. I think I'm coming in way too fast. But I can't tell because the game might be in fast motion. Well, propeller just hit the ground. Oh shit. Yeah. Why is that red? Successful landing. Two left aircraft. Handley page. Oh, that'll be why the game was going slow. Spad 7. And then over here. Albatross destroyed. That was a friendly all the way down there. Mind you, there is a front line right here. So really it's not that far behind enemy front lines. We took off, came all the way down here, got to the balloon, turned around and came straight back. Alright. That's day one, technically day two done. Same error that I did last time. Enemy plane's been spotted crossing our front lines. Intercepted attackers, let's just proceed with that and see what they do. See one heavy aircraft. He got one heavy. A total of three heavy. All right. Oh, I think the next mission is 6 p.m. the same day. Escort attackers. We're escorting planes. I'm in a normal one this time, a D7 non-F version. So Are they coming from here? Charleston 1? Probably. Alright, that's all for today. See you next time, whoever's watching.